Hey everyone, it's Heather Nichols. I had some fun this week playing with my simple strip sentiments, and I paired them with a balloon-shaped die to create this fun birthday card. Let's take a look at the supplies I used. I'm using the simple strips birthday stamp along with the simple strips die. I'm using the main balloon shape from the Celebrate Big balloon shaker die, along with a couple of the dies from the balloon strings die collection. I'm using the Polka Party stencil, and along with that I have my pixie spray and my ink blending tool. I'll be blending ink with sugar cube ink, and so I like to use the blending tool for that. I'll be doing some heat embossing, so I have my white embossing powder, my Versamark ink, and my powder tool. I'll also use my heat tool to melt the embossing powder. I'll add some ink spatters to my project using sugar cube ink refill and an acrylic block and a water brush. And finally, for an adhesive, I'll be using the foam squares along with the foam sticky strips. I'll be stamping the Simple Strips birthday stamp on three different colors of cardstock. I'll set this up in my Misti. Close the lid to pick up the stamp, and then add the cardstock into the Misti. I have some adhesive behind so that it will stay in place. I'll condition my cardstock with the powder tool so that embossing powder won't go everywhere. And then I'm going to ink up my stamp with Versamark ink, and I'll close the lid of the Misti to stamp the sentiments onto the cardstock. Once the sentiments are stamped, I'll add white embossing powder, and then I'll use my heat tool to melt the embossing powder and emboss the sentiments. I'll repeat this process to add the sentiments to Granny Smith cardstock and blueberry cardstock. Next, I'll cut out all of these sentiments using the coordinating simple strips die. This die will cut out all of the sentiments on each cardstock piece with one pass through the die cut machine. I'll line the die up with the square alignment guides on the stamped image, and I'll send it right through my machine to cut them out. I'll be attaching a bunch of the sentiment strips together onto a piece of cardstock, and so I'm taking a paper trimmer and I'm trimming off the notched end on each end of the sentiment so that they'll fit together really nicely. I did choose a few of the sentiments and I left the notched ends on, and I'll use those as sentiments on my project. I cut 2 3x3 squares from pieces of sugar cube cardstock. You could use another color of cardstock that you have, and you're not really going to see it because it's going to be behind all of these strips. I'm adding adhesive to the square, and then I'm going to fit the sentiment strips on in a sort of pattern to cover the whole piece of cardstock. While I'm covering the cardstock, I'm making sure that none of the colors that are the same are touching each other, and I'm varying where the sentiments are so that no sentiments that are the same are next to each other. Once I have sentiments where I want them, I'm also trimming the extra ends that are extending out beyond the edge of that sugar cube cardstock. I'll take each of the squares that I just put together with the simple strips, and I'll die cut the balloon, which is part of the Celebrate Big balloon shaker die collection, and I'll die cut a balloon from each of the pieces. For some strings for my balloons, I'm using a piece of sugar cube cardstock. I'm backing that cardstock with a piece of Stick-It, and then I'll run that piece of cardstock with the balloon strings dies through my die cut machine. I'm creating a background for my card front with the Polka Party stencil, and I'm going to use pixie spray to attach that to a piece of Toffee cardstock, and then I'll use my ink blending tool and add sugar cube ink through the holes of the stencil to apply the Polka Party pattern to the piece of cardstock. I'll also add a few splatters of sugar cube ink by adding a drop of sugar cube ink refill onto an acrylic block. I'll pick that up with a water brush. I'll tap the water brush over my finger to add the splatters to my background. Before I add my Simple Strips balloons to my card front, I die cut an additional balloon with a solid piece of cardstock in blue raspberry and blueberry cardstock colors, and I'm just offsetting those behind the balloons, the Simple Strips balloons, just to give them a little bit more definition on the card front. I'll use foam squares to attach the balloons to the card front to pop them up just a bit from the background. I'll peel the paper backing off of the balloon strings from the Stick-It, and then I'll attach these to the card background, tucking the ends under the balloon so they look like they're attached. I'll attach this to a sugar cube card card base, I'll align the top edges of both pieces so just a little bit of sugar cube peeks out at the bottom of the card. Finally, I'm adding a few of the sentiments from the Simple Strips birthday set. This is the strips that I left the notches on the ends. I'll pop those up using foam sticky strips and attach those right across the bottom of the card. I hope you liked this fun idea on a different way to use your Simple Strips and pairing it with a die cut to create some unique die cut shapes for your next project. You can use Simple Strips you already have in your collection that you've already stamped, or stamp new ones for your project. You can find all of the Simple Strips products, as well as the other supplies that I use to create this project, in the Tailored Expressions web store at tailoredexpressions.com. Thanks so much for joining me, everybody, and I'll see you next time.